Good morning, everybody. We hope your Wednesday's off to a great start. I'm Juan Tinajero.
And I'm Sahil Mithal. We've got an exciting episode for you all today, so let's get right into it.
It's March 4th, and you're watching BHS-TV.
Let's kick things off today with our first edition of Game Day.
Let's see how much three of our fellow students at BHS know about our school. Sending it over to Chris Kaleko.
What is up, BHS? I'm Chris Kaleko, and I'm here with a new segment called Game Day. Let's meet our new contestants today.
Hi, I'm Bryn Smith, and I'm a sophomore. I play soccer.
My name is Kyle Varak. I'm a sophomore here. I once had a betta fish that lived for 3 years.
Very cool, Kyle.
I'm JD Swarbrick, and I'm also a sophomore. I play baseball for the Broncos.
That's Jake. The rules to this game are simple. Each contestant has a buzzer in front of them, and when you have the answer, simply click the button. All right, let's begin with our first question. The first question today is, when was the current location of Barrington High School built?
1933.
Incorrect.
1960?
Nope.
It was in 1948.
1949, but I say we give it to him.
For sure.
All right, so after that question correct by Kyle, the score is 1 for Kyle Horak, 0 for Glam Fan Bryn Smith, and 0 for JD Swarbrick. Let's hit this next question. How many National Board Certified Teachers do we have at our school?
It's 14.
Yes, that is correct, Kyle.
I'm cooking with gas.
Oh, yeah. The score is now 2 for Kyle Horak, 0 for Bryn Smith, and 0 for JD Swarbrick. Come on, guys. Kyle's about to run away with this one.
Comeback time.
All right. This next question is for the athletes watching in their classroom. So, how many state championships has Barrington Athletics won?
21.
So close to no cigar.
12?
I believe that is correct. Point for Bryn Smith. The score is now 2 for Kyle Horak, 1 for Bryn Smith, and 0, sadly, for JD Swarbrick. We're now on to the final question, with the score being Kyle Horak, 2 points, Bryn Smith, 1 point, and JD, well, he's getting there. Anyway, let's go into our last question. So, how many people can Barrington Community Stadium fit at a given time?
4,262.
Incorrect, Kyle. Your chance to tie.
5,000?
Also incorrect.
I want to say 4,000.
You know what? Good enough, man. That's correct.
Yes!
Well done, man. Alright, after that final round, the final score is 1 point for Bryn Smith, 1 point for JD Swarbrick, and our winner for today's first episode, Kyle Horak. Kyle, you got anything to say?
I would just like to thank Nicholas Neff over there, Mr. New Haven, and Senor Donate.
Thank you so much for coming on, everyone, and we will see you next week on Game Day.
Congrats to Kyle Horak for winning this episode of Game Day.
Make sure you stay tuned for future episodes. Now let's send it over to Riley Trapp for this week's edition of Barrington Sports Desk.
Good morning, BHS, and welcome back to another edition of Barrington Sports Desk. As always, I'm Riley Trapp. To end the show, we'll see how some of our favorite athletics teams did, as well as preview some upcoming matchups. It's March 4th, and you're watching Barrington Sports Desk. First on the show is girls basketball, who after defeating Auburn 54-52 in the sectional semifinals, the Phillies were defeated by Dundee Crown in the sectional championship. Congratulations on a great season, Phillies. Next up is boys swimming and diving. The 200-meter relay in the state tournament, consisting of Daniel Langlois, Sean UGA, Jack Hoppe, and Griffin O'Leary, received 10th in the state meet. Also, Griffin O'Leary received 4th in the 100-meter fly with a time of 49.4 seconds. Also, he set a school record in the process. Also, Griffin O'Leary received second place in the 100-meter backstroke, so congratulations to all the swimmers. Next up is Bronco basketball, who played their first playoff game yesterday against Prospect. At the time of this recording, the outcome has yet to be decided. Next up is the Bronco wrestling team, who took third place in the team state tournament, so congratulations to all the wrestlers on a great season. Next up, I'll have a chance to interview Bronco wrestler Evan Roper. Welcome, Evan.
Hey, it's an honor to be here, Riley.
Is it really?
No.
All right. Well, what got you into wrestling as a kid?
Well, initially I got into wrestling because it kind of helped with football when I was younger, but now it's become a bit of a passion of mine.
Mm-hmm. And who helped you the most this year?
I would definitely say Shin. He, throughout the end of the season, came back to practice with me, and he really prepared me for the state meet.
So what was your favorite memory from this year?
I think my favorite memory was definitely our duel versus Sandberg at Team State. Those first six matches when we went up 31-0, that was some of the most fun I've had all season.
All right, thank you to Evan Roper for coming. That's all we have for this week, and back to the studio.
Thanks, Riley. As Barrington Athletics come to a close this year, we'd like to congratulate all of our BHS athletes for their performance this year.
Now moving things along, here's an informational video about the cold and flu season.
Summer, that's so gross. Get out of here. Go to the nurse.
Hi. Are you going to pick up my pen now and write your name down on my log? After you coughed into your hand. Where should you be coughing?
In my arm.
Into your sleeve. Yes, ma'am. Thank you. Much better. It's flu season, people. Remember. Cover those coughs.
The nurses would like to remind everybody to stay home if you have any respiratory symptoms or a fever that's greater than 100.5 degrees. Students are also asked to notify the nurses if you've been diagnosed with the flu.
Finally, let's wrap up today's episode by sending it over to Dee Dee to get you in the know.
What's up, Barrington? I'm Dee Dee Bruces, and it's time to get you in the know. Calling all senior artists. Graduation is just around the corner. Mr. Zimka and the Senior Class Board are now accepting art and design submissions for the Class of 2020 graduation program covers. If you are a senior and would like to submit a design to be considered, look for these posters around school for design specifications or contact Mr. Zimka or Ms. Corey in the main office for details. The winner gets their design printed on the 2020 graduation ceremony program cover, recognition inside the program, and a special gift. Submissions due to Mr. Zimka by April 12th. Good luck, seniors. We are hosting a Sewing for Others event where we need students who can sew to help make dresses for girls in impoverished countries. Today on March 18th after school in room W119, volunteer hours will be given. Tonight, the Almost Spring Band concert will take place at 7 p.m. in the auditorium. Come support our talented musicians. Barrington High School Ultimate Frisbee is having an informational meeting this Friday in the Commons after school. For more information, prospective players can follow Barrington Ultimate on Instagram or email mberquist@bsd220.org. That's all for this week, Barrington. I'm Dee Dee Bruces, and now you're in the know.
Thanks, Dee Dee. That's all we have to show this week, Barrington. I'm Juan Tina Harrell.
And I'm Zaha Mithil. Thanks for tuning in, Barrington.